Now, we already knew that Melissa Leong was talented, but lo and behold, she's a poet as well as the queen of MasterChef. Listen to this here, OK? Hot chocolate is perfect for days when it's cold. Did you know it's from Mexico? It's actually quite old. Their version is perfumed, rich with warm spices. Try it sometime. You'll find it the nicest.
Oh!
That's good, isn't it? Yeah, that's from our new book
here. I love Melissa's little face as you were reading that too.
Then my kid's voice while I done that one, yeah.
A taste adventure with Melissa Leong, and the real deal is here in the flesh in our studio. It is always a pleasure to have you in here. Is there anything that you can't do? Did you really write this poetry all by yourself?
I really did. And I wasn't planning on it being a rhyming book to begin with because I'm a food and travel writer. I just thought it would be slightly more prosaic, but it just emerged out of my brain in that rhyming kind of vernacular. So I just decided to go with it.
Do you know, there's not a generation that doesn't love you. So why a children's book?
Yeah.
Well, because, you know, in this job, people are like, when are you coming out with a book? And I'm just for jokes, I thought, well, instead of doing something serious and cookbooky or autobiographical, I just flip it on its head and just come out with a kid's book. And I like the idea because it's explaining the sensations of taste to little kids.
But don't you reckon writing for kids is harder, though?
So God,
I'll just go the easy option. I'll just put, like, pretty pictures in a book and then you're like, whoa, how do I explain umami taste to a child?
Well, conceptually, I was like, oh, I thought I was being really smart. I was like, how about we explain the sensations of taste to, like, 6 to 8-year-old kids? Publisher was like, yep, that's really great. Victoria's in the back, hey. And then I sat down to write it and I was like, how do you do this? So my hat goes off to people who do this for a living on a regular basis because it is really tough.
It's funny. I had a conversation with my 4-year-old only on the weekend and he said, what's sour taste like?
Yeah.
And I was like this.
That's sort of what I leaned
into. It's actually really hard to explain it, right?
That's sort of what I leaned into, is sort of describing how certain flavours feel, using onomatopoeia as well, and then associating dishes with them so that kids can annoy their parents by going out and asking for them.
Oh, so that's so good.
It is so great. Yeah, and you've just been in Japan as well promoting this book in bookstores and all over the media. How are you feeling about that? This is fantastic.
I'm very, very excited. I'm doing a book signing in Dimmicks in Sydney tomorrow, so please come. Hi, I'm here. That'd be really lovely to see you. It's pretty crazy. I'm getting a little nervous that, you know, it's like people will turn up to my party? I don't really know.
This is going to be like your year, like the Gold Logie nomination. You've got a hit show, you've got podcasts, you've got a book.
Mm.
Got your new album coming out.
Yeah, what's your new album?
Yeah, absolutely. Dropping any moment.
And on top of all of this as well, you are such a style icon. Oh, everything you wear is so fierce. And you said something really interesting once. You've said beauty is treated as a frivolous thing, but those who understand its power would dare to disagree. What do you mean by that?
I think that fashion and style is such a great form of expression. You can say so much about yourself without having to say a word, and isn't that a powerful tool that you can use? So I think that when people sort of say, oh, makeup's a little bit silly or fashion's a little bit frivolous, it's a billions dollar industry, I should say. You know, there are so many people's creativity and jobs all wrapped up in that, and so to be able to celebrate that on a show like MasterChef, where people love the food but they also love the earrings and the makeup and the fashion as well, and if we can sell Australian businesses through that, then it's an honour.
Oh, I love that. And you work it every single time. Bar
those
snacks.
Pictures.
We talk about bar snacks, for example. You just bar snacks.
I do love
just throwing away all those pictures there. Yeah, they're fantastic.
You recently wrote you like bar snacks more than you like most people.
True.
Look, I've met a few arancini balls that are better than the people I've met in real life.
Haven't we all?
What's your favourite snack at the bar?
Well, I love sitting at a bar, you know, instead of sort of sitting at a table, you can sort of interact with the staff, you can look at what's going on around and just sort of soak up the atmosphere. I love dining alone. Like, I love just being in a restaurant by myself and just experiencing that. So it depends on where I'm at. You know, I've had bar snacks that involved deep-fried tarantulas in Cambodia. That was pretty great.
Wow.
Yeah, just, you
know. Tastes like chicken?
soft-shell crab, weirdly.
Oh,
I call it the soft-shell crab of the jungle because it sort of has that that soft kind of outer sort of coating, and it's delicious. And it's all about the dipping sauce anyway.
And you're on holiday as well.
Yeah. Yeah, I have to go back to those pictures. Sorry, I was taken by all those pictures. They're absolutely beautiful. One of the pictures, this one here, that was while you were filming 10's Luxury Escapes in the Northern Territory. We know how beautiful that is. That episode is airing tomorrow, Saturday at 6 p.m. What did you do up there? Well, I mean, was it amazing?
Well, that's
I had a great
time. And Cam Datto on Segways. So strap yourselves in. It's a bumpy ride. We had the best time just touring around Uluru and also Kings Canyon as well. And it's a place in the world that I have come to love so much, just the Northern Territory in general, because there are so many different landscapes to explore. And I've just been up there for the last week in the Tiwi Islands and out in Finniss River as well. And, helicopters and all sorts of amazing, dramatic, beautiful views. It really makes me think... Australians are so intrepid, we love to go overseas, but actually some of the greatest adventures we can have are right here in our own backyard.
Yeah, it's such a spiritual and sacred place to see as well.
It's the most beautiful country in the world. I can't get enough of everything that you do, and now my kids can't get enough of this either. Melissa's book is called A Taste Adventure with Melissa Leong, and thank you so much for joining us today. Keep kicking goals, you're awesome.
Thank you so much.
Yay! The only woman I've seen to wear a red lip to the red centre and it not smudge at all. There we go.